Hello, my name is Akeem, and I am the founder of Sovereign America, and this is Freedom Fighters.
You might remember him from blockbusters such as his Soft Set Masterclass, where he pulled nonsense from his accordion-looking briefcase. And it looks like he's got that thing with him again, so pull up a chair for another masterclass in dipshittery. Now this is a shorter, but sweeter one, and it's best accompanied by a shanty. So here we go.
This is not legal advice. I'm not a lawyer. I'm not an attorney. This is just what has worked for others. It's simply an educational segment.
Now, Akeem, these others, are they a figment of your imagination? Or in other words, citation needed.
So what I wanted to touch on right now is is how to retain your freedoms in all places at all times, okay? An example of how not retaining your freedom can affect you, okay? If any of you guys have ever been served a summons to court, it's done by a person in plain clothes. They're kind of incognito, like they catch you at home with your kids, just pulling up, unloading the groceries, and somebody comes up to you and they say, "Hey, Darren," and you say, "Yeah."
You know how you could actually avoid this kind of thing, not having a summons to appear in court, you know, not having a warrant for your arrest, you know, obeying the law. You keep talking about freedoms, but with freedoms comes responsibility as well. But you guys always want all the freedoms without any responsibility. That's not how society works. Might wanna step back into reality.
And then when you say yeah, what you're doing is admitting jurisdiction. Remember that. If you say yes to that name, you're admitting jurisdiction.
Wow, that sounds like you're trying to sell some kind of get out of jail free card. So what are you gonna say then? No? For fuck's sake, man.
So as soon as you say yeah, they're gonna hand you that piece of paper and tell you you've been served. They're probably gonna have a recording, audio, and visual device. And they're gonna be able to say, "Well, hey, Judge, this guy didn't show up to court after we summoned him and served him his subpoena. Let's go ahead and issue a warrant." So the way you don't even allow them to get you into court is when they say, "Hey, Darren," you say, "No."
All right. That was a joke, man. You say no. Hey, actually, hey, remember when you said, I'll be right back, by the way.
Right? And it works the same way with law enforcement. If they say, "Hey, Darren," and you say no, and they say, "Well, who are you?" You say, "Well, who are you?"
Yeah, and what's next? You're gonna say the floor is lava and jump on your car? I mean, that is kind of the level of logic you're using here. And I use that term very loosely.
Do you have a claim against me, officer? Do you know of anyone that has a claim against me? Do you got a victim accusing me of crime? Who dispatched you here? I don't know you. They're gonna say, "So this isn't you?"
So wait, let me get this straight. They have a picture of you or a description of you, and you are basically telling them you are not you. You are someone else. Or maybe you are actually no. You wouldn't be Dr. No, now would you? Is that you? Oh wait, you weren't you. You were actually no. And this is getting confusing real quick. I mean, refusing to English is a crime, where I'm concerned.
No, that's not me. Well, who are you? Well, what crime are you investigating? Because I don't have to tell you who I am. The Fourth Amendment protects me from that. The Fourth Amendment is the right of the people to be secure in their person, houses, papers, and effects against unreasonable searches and seizures. No warrant shall be issued without oath or affirmation of the person, places, things to be seized, officer.
But upon probable cause, supported by oath or affirmation, and particularly describing the place to be searched, and the persons or things. Quite amusing this Dick Flute chose to leave that part out, almost as if he's trying to do some dipshittery on purpose.
Oh, speak up, man. Are you? I'll take that as a yes. But to be honest, dipshittery is kinda expected. It is, after all, their bread and butter.
Damn straight. That is a good point, Radical.
Uh-huh. And I noticed you are enjoying using my wordy bits.
Well, I simply like those wordy bits you come up with. I'll see you around.
Yep, and thanks for calling him out for, you know, dipshittery.
So, remember, retain your freedoms in all places, at all times. Just because you hear your name doesn't mean you have to respond to it. Remember that. Ask questions. Be smart. fight for your freedom. Remember to like, subscribe, and share. Freedom fighters.
I have no words for this. For the YouTube endgame. Do you have words for this? Show me in the comments. I have literally no words for this. It was so dumb. But remember to tickle the bell and I'll bounce around, and then I will see you in the next video. That is a bit longer than this one because this was a bit short. But hey, it's not my fault. His classes are short and sweet. Well, short and smelly, more likely. So, yeah. Bye-bye. Imagine this guy going to Starbucks and getting his name read out. It's probably no on his cup.